U.S. President Joe Biden now in Northern Ireland for a three-day visit. Biden was greeted by British Prime Minister Rishi Sunak as he landed in near Belfast. The American leader arrives at a delicate political time in Northern Ireland as he helps mark the so-called Good Friday peace deal that largely ended 30 years of bloodshed there. He is expected to meet with representatives from the five main Northern Irish parties on Wednesday. Dozens have been killed in airstrikes in Myanmar. The exact toll in the strike on the remote Sagaing region is still unclear, but local media estimate at least 50 are dead. The military has admitted to carrying out that air raid, saying it targeted an office of an alleged militia group opposed to the junta. The military spokesman then went on to blame mines planted by the militias for the civilian deaths. The United Nations, Germany, and the United States have condemned the attack. In sports, the Atlanta Hawks clinch the Eastern Conference's seventh seed with an easy 116-105 victory against the Miami Heat in their NBA play-in showdown. Seven Hawks scored in double figures, led by Trae Young's 25 points. Atlanta raced off to a 15-point lead at the half and never looked back. The Hawks now move on to the playoffs, where they will face the second seed Boston Celtics. The Heat, on the other hand, will play the winner of the Toronto-Chicago play-in game for the East's eighth seed. Well, tropical depression Amang maintains its strength even after making two landfalls. Let's get more details now from ABS-CBN resident meteorologist Ariel Rojas. Ariel, over to you.
Hi, Carmina. Good afternoon. Tropical depression Amang has already made two landfalls, first over Pangalibot, Catanduanes, 10 p.m. last night, and second in Presentacion, Camarines Sur, 1 a.m. today. Tropical depression Amang was last spotted over the coastal waters of Caramoan, Camarines Sur, maintaining its maximum winds of 45 kilometers per hour and gusts up to 55 kilometers per hour. Amang is now slowly moving northwestward. Tropical cyclone wind signal number 1 remains hoisted over Catanduanes, Sorsogon, Albay, Camarines Sur, Camarines Norte, Gurias and Tikau Islands in Masbate, most of Quezon including Polillo Islands, eastern portion of Laguna, almost the entire province of Rizal, eastern Bulacan, eastern Nueva Ecija, and Aurora. Gusty conditions are experienced in these areas. Heavy rains will continue to batter Camarines provinces and Quezon today. The rest of Bicol and Calabarzon, most of Mimaropa, central Luzon, the eastern section of Cagayan Valley, as well as northern Samar, Capiz, Aklan, and Antique will also be rainy. Flooding and landslides in these areas remain a threat. Amang will continue to move northwestward in the coming hours and graze the northern portions of Camarines Sur and Quezon before weakening into a low-pressure area over central Luzon tomorrow afternoon. The weather disturbance will still bring rains over central and southern Luzon until Friday. Here in Metro Manila, rains this afternoon will start until the evening with short breaks in between. And as the latest on the weather, back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Ariel Rojas there joining us live. Tropical depression Amang unleashed strong winds and intermittent rains in the province of Catanduanes. But local disaster management officials say the situation in the province has started to improve. They add the local government remains on alert for possible landslides. Signal number 1 is still raised over Catanduanes.
Lahat naman po na area sa Catanduanes ay susceptible sa landslide. Although hindi na katulad nung panahon na talagang konting ulan na talagang naglalandslide. Sa ngayon po, medyo nagkaroon na ng stability. In 2 years na situation namin dito, nabawasan na po yung nasa monsoon season tayo, yung northeast monsoon, nabawasan na yung mga landslide.